Commodore is a web-based Kubernetes troubleshooter. It doesn't replace existing monitoring and logging tools, but it does analyze those tools or connect to them and look at the data, as well as looking at your Kubernetes cluster and helps you determine its current state and track anything that might go wrong and basically help you discover where things could have gone wrong with your deployments, updates, the health of pods, or the cluster itself. So on my live show, I had ETL Schwartz, the CTO and co-founder of Commodore, to talk about what the product does, the point of it all, what are they going for with this app, and to give a demo. So I thought it would be great to just break that all down into a key demo of what it does right out of the box. Now, if you like this little demo video, then you can watch the whole show or listen to the podcast audio only version with the links below.
So I give like a high level overview of how we see the world at the moment. And this is like a simple example of what I just said. And you have like the alert production channel and the PagerDuty just notified you that there is an issue. You go to Datadog and you see the CPU is high. Maybe you do kubectl describe or kubectl get status or something like that. What changed and what's the current status of your pods? Then you go to Jenkins because you search like for the last change that happened. And out from the Jenkins, you usually go to the GitHub to see what code changed and who changing. And you ended up going to Slack and basically asking people who changed what, why, and when, and because does this explain like the high latency or high CPU I'm experienced? So this is how like Commodore see, like this is the world prior to Commodore. And now let me do like a screen sharing on our platform and I'll do a live demo of the product itself. 1 second, dashboard, Commodore. Yeah. Okay. Great. So this is the Commodore main screen. And here you have Commodore on top of Commodore, basically eating our own dog food. And you can see here all of the services that are up and running in Commodore. And when I'm saying like service, what I really mean is a deployment, a stateful set, or a daemon set. And for each one of those services, we have a tile and we have the specific namespace or cluster. So this gives you like a high level overview of your system. And because we play nicely with existing annotation and existing labels that you have, we can see the world like as Commodore see it or as our dev team see it. So I can see all of the pods that are using Postgres, or maybe I can go and see all of the front end tools. So you have like Slack, the web, the admin, and the GraphQL. We're a big believer in GraphQL. You can digest the world like by the language that the pod is currently running. And like I said, we use Python. We also use TypeScript. And basically, this is like the high level overview of the system. Now let's go and do go to a specific like service that I have here open. And here you have everything that changed inside that specific service. And like I said, the service is basically a deployment in the last 24 hours. So all of these like green, nice green things are basically a deployment. Deployment means something that has changed inside your Kubernetes manifest. And when I click on a deployment, I can see like a deep dive on what really changed. So when I mean what really changed, then it means something very similar to that. So this is basically a diff, not a GitHub diff, but a YAML diff taken from inside Kubernetes to show you the actual diff inside your cluster. So I can go back in time and see what really changed inside my cluster. And I can go like to this deployment or this deployment. And you can see that we are releasing quite frequently, and to see everything that changed as part of the YAMLs. We also show you like changes that happen inside configment or something else that is not necessarily like Kubernetes specific. Here on the right side, you don't really don't have only like the Kubernetes, because it's interesting, but it's not the only interesting thing that you have, but also all of the GitHub changes that happen. So basically, think about it like as a time machine, and you can see everything that changed as part of the bigger thing, meaning like the GitHub changes. So this is like the Commodore main screen. We really like this timeline. And let me show you how it looks like when things aren't as pretty. I have like some examples here. So let's look on the payment listener application, which is another service where we have like inside our cluster. And here you can say that you had a deployment, but sadly for us, we failed. And that is because there was an issue with downloading the manifest, like the manifest for this image didn't really work. Afterward, there was a deployment that was successful, which is great. And I can see that the image changed from latest with a typo to latest, which is really great. And we fixed the issue. But after this thing, I can see here that like you have this yellow thing, and it means that the service was unhealthy for, I see that for 4 minutes, the service was unhealthy. It didn't have all the minimum replicas. Someone tried to fix it. And then basically when I say fix it, it tried to deploy a newer version. And again, it failed because there was a typo. And after like after more time, I can see everything went back to normal. And basically there was a version and now the service is healthy because I can see here it's healthy and it has 2 out of 2 replicas. And so what Commodore does, basically this very neat timeline shows you everything that you need to know in a single place. And let me show like another quick example and then I take some questions maybe on the product. 1 second, alert processor. Okay, so here you have like a not so happy state of service that was deployed, which is great. But afterward, there was the health change, meaning the service was unhealthy. There was a sentry exception, which is always bad. Then there was a Datadog alert. And other than that, we also track like external services. So I can see that there was an issues with GitHub or Azure. So in order to fetch the data that you see here, like the Kubernetes diff, the GitHub diff, the sentry exception and the Datadog monitor without using Commodore, basically what you need to do is to open 5 different tabs and to keep track out of each of them. And while using Commodore, you have all of this context, all of the data that you really need, all lined up in 1 single place. I think I will show you like 1 last thing and then like maybe okay. I'll open it for a little more questions. So you have here like the single timeline, but I also have like other services that might be related to my use case. And I can go here and see, let's see all of the Node.js application. And I can see that this is all of the Node application and I can add them to my timeline. So I can see everything that changed, not only for my service, but for all of the application that might be related. And I can see the timeline, just it was just added like Datadog app. And I can also add, maybe I find something interesting, the web API. And I can add basically all of the application that I want and to see everything on 1 single timeline. And okay, this comes to address the issue that happens in once you have like, I don't know, like 6 developers and you start having teams and people don't really know what other people are deploying at the moment. So this comes to answer this question, mainly like what changed not only for my services, but on the neighborhood. So right, this is like a very quick sneak peek of Commodore.
If you like this clip, give it a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe and click the bell to get notification when I go live most Thursdays with guests for you to come on and learn about Docker, Kubernetes, and DevOps topics. Oh, and here's some other videos that you might like on these similar topics.